Hello, guys.
Wolf. Wolf. Wolf.
What a dog. What a dog. Wolf is welcome you back to the project that he's managing at the moment, and as you can see, he's very happy to see you. Is that right, Wolf? Yeah. So guys, let's get back to this beautiful ship. Today we're going to begin the planking of the hull. Always the first boards that you, wood strips, call them whatever you like, that you place on the hull are very crucial, because that will determine everything else. Because above and below these specific wood strips that we're going to place as the first ones, every other wood strip will determine if the hull will be correct or wrong. Of course, it's wood, so many mistakes will be fixable. It's better not to make any, but okay, we can fix a lot of mistakes. So, let me gather my tools, my equipment, and place the camera on a tripod, and we will begin to place the first wood strip. So guys, let's begin. The first wood strip that we're going to place begins from here, exactly at its height, and then it ends up over here. So, first of all, you have to mark where to cut. Needs some adjustment. It's perfect. Now, to align it, let me check something. Give me a moment. Now, this will be exactly over here, like this. It's aligned. Not entirely, but let me check. It's going to be aligned at the bottom. As I can see, also the other one. So we have to align them at the lower part over here. Okay. And over here, we're going. This has been unglued, as you can see, but I will glue it again now. This must be aligned over here at the lower part. So let's begin by gluing this piece. again. And start to glue this too. Let me get my pin. Let's glue the other end as well. Perfect, it's aligned, it's perfect. But the cyanoacrylic glue is just to keep the wood strip in position. In the entire hull, we're going to use white glue as well. Now, I will leave the glue to dry, and after the glue is dry, I will do the other side as well, and I'll get back to you to continue the planking. So guys, the glue is dry for this part over here. So it's time to throw on another wood strip. Here I'm not going to remove this pin yet because I have pressed down the wood to have a small curve. You will understand now why, because this is where the wood strip will go. And as you can see, I have a gap. Don't mind about that. I will close it even with a small piece of wood or wood putty, because everything is going to be painted. So no worries about anything over here. But by pushing down this piece, I make the cap to be smaller, and that's the idea. So we have to place another piece of wood. This wood needs to be bended slightly, not a lot, slightly. Have in mind that this ship has a very small curve over here. The bigger is at the stern. So over here we don't need to have too much of bending, too much bending. Also, you can see that the wood strip won't make it all the way to the stern. So first of all, I'm going to measure with the wood strip over here, covering half of this piece. What I'm going to break, to cut, is at the front, at the bow. So this is the place where I need to bend. This is the spot. So right here needs a bending over here, and this will go all the way. So over here and here needs more bending, and we will cut right about there. Now let me remove the camera and put it over the soldering iron. Many people ask me how much is the time that I soak the wood strips in water. The answer is seconds. You just have to make sure that the wood strip is always wet. You don't have to soak it 20-30 minutes for this type of wood, and of course for this thickness. This is 2 millimeter. This is very flexible wood, as you can see. So you can see it's dry. Now you can see it's wet. 1 second, maybe less. I need to get it wet over here. Give a moment. And now it's wet all the way. So slightly bend, slightly, not much, slightly. And over here, just a little more. I believe that would do the trick. Let me just check it. Give me a moment. I'm doing a test run, and it's perfect. Now, as you can see, very little. Let me dry the wood. Let me move the camera again to throw the piece on. Now, let's begin from here. Cyanoacrylic glue. compressor. The Titanic is a little bit different than the other models. It's long enough, and as you can see, the gaps in between are very much apart. So be careful if you glue the wood strips, not to bend the wood strip like this on the inside, because it's fixable, all right. But it's going to be a little bit hard to do that. This is a ship that's going to be painted, so we're going to use a lot of wood putty. No worries about gaps. Try to have as less as you can and as small as you can. But even though, if you get any gaps, there's no nothing wrong with that. It's absolutely normal, and we're going to use a lot of wood putty. Now, according to the plans, I must end up over here. So, I must follow the hull and glue. And definitely here, I'm going to need pins. We have a gap here. It seems larger than it is because the wood strip is lower in height. It's like this, so the gap looks larger, but it is not. It's something that if you sand it down, it will be much smoother, and with some wood putty or even some piece of wood will be as it never existed. So now here, another pin here. This will be filled up with another wood strip. This is going to be a little bit hard. We will do it together. It requires a lot of time, but we'll do that. And we're going to try to make the wood strip fit as better as we can. We haven't finished yet. We still have the rest. So, another wood strip. And I will continue with a different pattern in this ship. Doesn't make any difference because, like I said, everything is going to be sanded down and we'll use wood putty and paint. So one wood strip will go over to this, one wood strip will go over to this. So the next one will be like this, not have them all in the same side for better strength. Now, let's see how this will end up. We need to have a gentle curve over here. So from here, we have curves. You see what we're going to do. This will end up, I hope it's visible, will end up over here. I'm cutting it a little bit more than I need. So let's do that again. We need to twist the wood like this. Let me get it soaked wet. We need to twist the wood like this. We get water. I don't want to get any water on the ledge. As you can see, I have a twist. Need a little more. Now, what I need to do is bend it this. Give me a moment. And I have a bend. So I have a twist and a bend. With some pins, it would stay over here and it's going to be great. Let's glue it. All right. Now to use some white glue in each and every joint. Let me do it all and I'll get back to you. And got it. Of course, I'm going to throw another piece and I'll get back to you to show you the finishing result. And got another one. I would love to throw on a third one, but I won't do that because the glue is not dry yet, the white glue that is, and maybe I will experience some problems. Never throw more than three wood strips at the same time. At this point, the first one is okay because the glue is dry. I could throw a third one, but I believe it's kind of risky, especially here at the stern, because the curving is a lot, it's big. So I won't take the chance to throw a third one. We have some gaps to close on, we have some gaps here. As you can see, here is a big gap, also this one, don't know when to, if we're going to close that right now. I believe it's going to be in the next, yeah, definitely in the next video. This gap here, as I can see, it stays like it is. Probably when we throw the piece, because here there's going to be a piece, probably we're going to need to close up the gap with a small piece of wood, because there are going to be some gaps or some wood putty. We will see at the time. Everything's fixable, nothing is wrong. Here we have the, let's say, bigger gap. Like I said, it's very easy to fix. We're going to throw a small piece of wood with some sanding. Maybe we'll do that together to show you how it is, and some wood putty. Also, we have to close up this gap here. So in our next video, I believe we're going to close this gap, the gap on the stern, and maybe do some work over here to show you how it's done. Thank you very much for watching, guys. See you soon.